Yeah, I know the beginning sounds like her doing her normal thing, but trust me, it gets better. Mr. Hater.
I guess they're like, gotta get respect for that, for this, for
yeah,
hey,
you gotta. You got,
whatever.
She's owning
because
up.
Most YouTubers don't do that.
Wealth is created by two things: courage,
great,
and
the
willingness to hurt.
Apologize for those before. I look back to my apologies in the past, and I'm ashamed of them. They are so half-assed and bad, and they're literally just straight.
Okay, info.
Huh? What'd you say? I couldn't hear you.
Okay, enough of that. Restored. Her voice is annoying.
Coming at you! Quit using my air!
So.
Compensated later.
Am I angry about the whole PewDiePie
right?
thing? Well.
Yeah.
I mean, he's getting more likes and everything than he's actually losing, if you think about it. Because everybody's
yeah,
on his side.
Like, he actually gets... He actually ends up winning from this. He can... Now he's free from Disney, he can do whatever he wants. But
I mean, I thought he was already doing all of his things. I mean...
It's very disgusting. It's still very disgusting how he is treating him. Anyways.
They're calling him off for being racist. I think he's just so stupid. It's crazy. Like, that's all I just see it as. This is just way crazy. And if you think about it, like, H3H3 said, Walt Disney was a racist. Like, he was out with the racist. And, he pretty much owns them, so I don't know why. If PewDiePie was racist, they would kick his ass out, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And, did you see Casey Neistat's video?
No, I did not. I did not want to watch.
I don't want to watch Casey Neistat.
Well, he showed a clip of it.
You would make this discussion way more better if you watched the video. I don't really think Casey Neistat was against PewDiePie, as everybody is saying. Like, I see why they think that, but I don't think he really was. I mean, he doesn't like the joke, but I don't think he's against PewDiePie for it. I know he says, like, oh, you're a big YouTuber, you should be pretty much watching what you're saying. But if you think about it, there's some truth to that. Like, you're pretty much the face of the company. Like, I know you want to have, like, fun and everything. But you know, being the top of the, you have like a responsibility, he said, which is pretty true. Like
yeah,
I know.
But in the end of the day, it's not about who's right. It's not about being on here or on their side. It's about he's going with the net that PewDiePie was being is being raped by the media made up. That's not okay.
Yeah, I know he didn't mention that at all, like how they're pretty much ruining
from what
him.
I saw in Drama Alert. But I know.
Your mic is lagging in and out. You should really fix that. But with the Keemstar thing, I think he's overdoing it. Like, he's straight. Being a Keemstar, but you know. Like, I see why he's doing that, and I give him respect for that, but I think he's just taking it a little too far with Casey Neistat. Like, if he's truly
I'm breaking out.
Let me know if he gets better.
What? No last word?
Is it better?
Yeah.
I forgot what I was saying. This game is really distracting me.
I'll pound you all into ash!
It's pretty understandable why Keemstar is the acting.
Yeah, because I can see in the video how it's like he looks like he's falling out.
So he's not.
You broke up. God damn it, dude. Your internet's straight trash.
Come on.
Okay, no. Not sure what you're saying. We're good now.
I understand why Akeem's not reacting in the same way that he does. He's worked for the most part, but how to respond to it is, I think he's kind of wrong about that.
Yeah.
To just do the same thing back to them. Reporting them as being liars, as racist or whatever. Mm-hmm. I don't believe that type of response.
But yeah, I don't think Casey Neistat deserves all the hate he's getting. He just doesn't deserve it. Like, he doesn't like the joke, but he doesn't... I don't think he likes how CNN and all of them, the big media, is treating PewDiePie. He said in his video that PewDiePie will bounce back from it. There's truth to that. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, everybody forgets. Like, the Tana Mojo will fly over. No one will remember that. I would have so much more to say.
He's an outspoken Hillary Clinton supporter, so yeah. He pretty much deserves hate for that little speech he gave.
Coming at you. Outgoing.
Your internet's straight trash. I'm sorry.
Yeah. So what were you talking about?
I completely forgot.
So by the way, podcasts usually have a couple of different picks per episode. So don't the 6 minutes just talking about different things.
Oh, you want to talk about different things in the podcast?
Yeah, then I would also well, do.
I'm sorry, jeez. You're talking shit to the editor? I'm sorry, to all the people that are listening, this episode's probably just fucked up and rambling and not really to the point because, one, our internets are trash right now. Second, Brandon didn't do his research. So, you know, I'm the only one here trying to throw some ideas and he doesn't know what the fuck I'm talking about because all he watches is that Keemstar. Even though all he got in his room is posters of Keemstar with X's over his face. Like, if you met Brandon like I did, you would know he got that vibe of a school shooter. So, Keemstar, watch out, bro. Looking out for you. Now, back to the whole 5 minute thing. I'm sorry for that video. Like, I pretty much told you I was gonna split it up like that. Like, with the Shay Carl and everything. That was gonna be episode 2, but then when I look back at what we talked about with that one, we only lasted about like a minute. I was like, a minute? Cannot upload that. And then with the Tana Mojo, I thought we had more minutes than that, but then when I broke it all down, got rid of the moments of silence, because there was a lot of silence, and it ended up being 5 minutes and 55 seconds. 555. So. And I also didn't mention this like I did in the other one. That was not the episode 1, but when we first tried recording. This whole podcast idea was Brandon's idea. So, not trying to say if this does badly, blame him. But you know. Gotta give him that shout out because this wasn't my idea. Although we both make the decisions for it, it was him that came up with the idea.
Yeah. You got any contenders for the third host?
I had one, and if he watches us when it comes out, Tonti, you little faggot. I still remember you disliked my last video, live while I was in the game in party chat with you. So if you dislike this one, I will shout out your YouTube channel. Not to send hate your way, but you know, because nobody watches my videos. But you know, yeah, just to fuck with you.
Who are you talking to?
I'm talking to someone that's gonna be in the audience. Okay, I'm foreshadowing. Like I'm talking to like future someone. Cause with the last episode, I was playing some Call of Duty with one of my friends.
Oh.
And he decided to mess with me and play. Huh?
Oh, this podcast.
No. 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 So when we posted that, like I was like saying, when I was playing Call of Duty with my friend, we were in a party chat, and he decided to mess with me by going on my YouTube channel and decided to play the video live where I can hear it, and he made fun of it a little bit, and he decided to dislike the video. So you know, kind of talking shit to him, so when he watches the video, he knows that I'm talking shit to him. Do you understand? I feel like you're still lost.
So anyway, how long should each episode be?
I don't know. Not too long, because, you know, we're not very big. So, you know, we don't want to bore people. It's only just the two of us. And since you don't do your research, you know, I'm kind of carrying you. I'm just playing. You want to try to keep it for a half hour?
I don't know.
Because if we're going to do like a half hour, we need more to talk about. Because when we're playing the game, it's pretty much just like gameplay. It wouldn't be like a podcast, like the last episode. Like if I posted like everything we were talking about, it wouldn't seem like a podcast. It would just seem like gameplay with Brandon, a let's play.
I don't know what you said.
God damn it, your shitty internet. It's your fucking free trial internet.
No, it wasn't the internet. It wasn't.
I can't even. You're breaking up. Like you'd be like, no.
That's Brandon. His best Brandon.
Brandon's best friend. What?
Brandon.
So right now we're just complete silence for no reason.
So
okay, here's some, like, yo, I had so many ideas to talk about every time it's when I'm about to go to sleep for work in the morning. I'd be like, okay, we could do this for in the podcast. We could talk about this. We could talk about that. But then when we get to the podcast, I'm all blanks. I try to write it down, but I still draw blanks. Like, I
always shooting blanks.
Fuck you. So, Brandon, why did
we
you
finish talking about the? Did we even finish that thing?
About what?
Well, I guess so. There's not much else to say.
About what? The Tana Mojo and
the PewDiePie situation.
PewDiePie? No, that's pretty much it. Well, you pretty much know that. It's fucked up by CNN.
I guess I'll the Tana Mojo thing.
Yeah, the Tana Mojo things. I think. Well. Now you're watching a video again? I swear if we get a strike because of you, I swear to God, Brandon, I'm gonna have to snitch on you about your plans to go to one of Keemstar's meetup and talk hella shit to him.
So, think actual apology or damage control?
That's actually a good question, because I can see it as both. Damage control or an actual apology? I don't really know. Like, I would think it'll be more damage control, though. Because
what's the point of it? The thing.
Well, because okay, so she talked about at the end about like how she felt like all the hate comments were kind of making her like sort of suicidal. That one, if it's true, like I don't know, like yeah, add it. But if it's just damage control, this video, then I don't think you should have added the suicide thing. Cause I don't know, it's just some. Cause it seems, since a lot of your criticism comes from like pandering, like another, I wouldn't say most of your criticism, but a lot of your criticism comes from like pandering to your fans. So to like bring up the suicide thing, if you're just doing damage control, I think it was kind of bad to bring up, like fucked up to bring up. But yeah. if you truly meant this apology, then I see it's a good thing to add in there. And yeah, your video was pretty, it was actually good. If you truly mean it, then you don't deserve the hate that you're getting now. But if this is all a, if this is just fake, if this is just fake, just to like get everybody to stop hating on you, then I would actually think you're a pretty bad person, wouldn't you say?
I think it's genuine.
I mean,
she
admits a lot of things. And if she's just saying that just to get, like, the hate taken away from her, then I think she's actually a bad person for that. But if she truly at least means a lot of it, then she doesn't, then she's not a bad person. It's just that she made mistakes. Like, she's apologizing for it. And any hate that she's getting now.
Yeah, when someone admits that all, of her BS is BS, that's pretty respectable.
Yeah. But I think she could have apologized more to iDubbbz. Like, I know she didn't hurt him, like, pretty much subscribers wise. Like, he pretty much gained a lot from it. But, she should have been like, I'm sorry, iDubbbz. I'm sorry I did this. I'm sorry I did that. She could have did more for him.
He definitely should have owed her. She definitely owed him an apology after all the things she said.
My Spanish is not that good, and for all the white people in the audience, Brandon's mom told him to stop peeing the bed. No, I'm just kidding.
No. That was my mom.
Or his grandmother told him to stop peeing the bed. They're running out of laundry soap. I'm just playing. But, yeah. So Brandon, for the channel, why did you decide to do the podcast and put it on my channel?
What?
Why did you decide you came up with the idea of putting it on my channel? How come you didn't want to just start another YouTube channel and just be like the full podcast? I did not bring it up saying like, hey, let's put it on my channel.
Other than my idea to put on your
boy,
yeah, doing all the editing.
I was more than happy in putting it on another channel, but you said put it on yours because you're more active on yours. That's what you said.
Yeah.
But why? Like, I would have been happy just putting it on a random other channel.
Then do that. Make a separate account.
You want me to make a separate account? Like, I'm not saying I don't like it on my channel, but, you know, I don't want it to be like it's more aimed towards benefiting me than it is you.
Hmm.
You see that? I'm a nice person. I care about you.
It should be like a, you know, after we name it and all, we should like do a Twitter account.
Well, I don't use Twitter. Also. Twitter's gay.
Well, yeah, but everybody's using it.
Just because everybody's using it doesn't mean I want to use it. I think I made a Twitter like 5 years ago. I was trying to download free illegal music. So, you know, I was dumb enough to be like, oh, maybe if I make a Twitter, I'll be able to get some songs. Download them for free. Don't know why I thought that, but I was like 12.
Maybe.
Or not 12.
Maybe come into contact with Colossus Crazy. And he'll like boost the channel, the show.
Boy, you just want to boost the channel. You think about them views, boy? Damn. Exposing Brandon right now.
I'm just trying to sell the Twitter account idea to you.
Is you trying to pitch that idea to me? I mean, if you want to do a Twitter, you can control the Twitter.
Anyway, I guess we should also be find a way to. I'll handle the audio version.
Yeah, we need to find out. Well, you don't want to use Skype, you bastard.
What?
Skype. Because you can't do it through the gameplay on the PlayStation. This is just ghetto-y recording.
Video version?
This is ghetto recording for a podcast.
I have a YouTube downloader where you can just download the audio of a video, so just do that and then upload it on the SoundCloud or wherever.
True.
That's what I was trying to do, but I guess the last episode was like too short, so I couldn't download the audio. Again, why I wanted to be longer.
Well, I wanted to do Skype so we just get the audio, so that it isn't just on this stupid SharePlay or whatever. On the PlayStation, because, you know, I can actually do more editing stuff. Because, you know, I bought that software for like $200 and I never used it. I mean, it's not that good. But, you know, you do more on the laptop than you can on the PS4 for editing. Make some decent thumbnails.
What happened to that editing software that you bought?
It's still sitting there on my laptop, not being used. Because the only way I'm going to get it onto my PC, besides putting it on YouTube pretty much, and as a private, and then going on my laptop, I mean, I could do it that way, and I'll probably get yelled at by people, be like, why didn't you just do that in the first place? And I'm going to say, because I'm lazy. So, you know, doing all that extra work to do the editing, I'm not all about that. Especially for having only like 10 subscribers. Not into doing all that maximum effort editing yet.
So,
what do you truly want the name of the podcast to be? We should come up with a name now. Well, it's only episode 2.
Two Idiots Gaming?
Well, we're getting a third member soon. So it can't be Two Idiots Gaming.
Mm-hmm. Three of us gaming?
Three of us gaming? I don't know, this just sounds too basic.
Good at naming.
You're bad at naming?
I repelled it.
Repel?
I think it's probably me repelled.
Yeah. I don't know. I just feel like we're being too close to other podcasts, like with the Keemstar Abated. Like, you know how we wanted to come up with an opposite name of that? We did that, but I don't know. For our podcast, I see like us going in a different direction. You know what I mean? Like, I want ours to be different from all the other podcasts.
I guess I like that one because it should, is like the perfect name for what Cast 33 should have been.
Yeah. Cast 33, be like Repel 33, something like that.
Repel 3.
Anyways, we need to come up with a name for ours. Well, do you plan to do, not just like record it on the gameplay, but like regular Skype calls?
How many minutes of silence is it gonna be to edit it out in this one?
How much silence? It's gonna be a lot. Like the last one, I think it was like 10 minutes of straight silence, like had to be edited out. And then when I got to like 7 minutes into the other pod, like for the one I was gonna upload, when I cut out all of the quiet time, it only got to the 5 minutes and 55 seconds. It's because we come on. Because we either are too busy during the day, so it's like, we come on, and it's pretty much, like, half-assed.
So,
like, me hitting you up, be like, oh, do you want to record in, like, 2 days or something? Then you'd be like, yeah. And then at that time, all the hype shit, I'd be, like, forgetting about. And then when we get to the podcast, I draw blanks. So I guess for episode 3, we'll try to come up with that name. Well, before episode 3, actually. Try to throw some ideas. If people are actually going to watch this video, comment down below. Tell us what name we should put.
Podcasts usually have very simple names, so I think 3 idiots on a... some whatever would be a pretty good name, whichever. Like a 3 people doing this.
Should we wait for the third person though? Once we find a third person, see, throw ideas with them too, since they're gonna be part of it too. They can help with the name.
Yeah.
Cause I feel like we're gonna pick a name for it. And they're not gonna like it. You know what I'm saying? But there's gonna be 3 of us.
Oh, that'll be a good idea. So.
Yeah. So they don't feel like they're just like an outcast coming in all. Like, while we did everything.
Anything else to talk about? Or. Are we done?
Well, we should just talk about random shit. I don't know. We'll make this longer. Because I feel like once I edit it out, it's gonna be like 5 minutes. You want to tell them some backstory about us? How long we've been friends and everything?
Sure, yeah. Yeah.
So, just so that the audience gets to know, like, how long we knew each other. So, I don't know Brandon in real life. I knew him since PS3, since I was a little faggot, cringy little faggot running around on the PS3. Yeah. I was playing that. This was, like, the time with PlayStation Home. Was a big thing. Used to go on Crackle and everything to the theaters. Oh my god. This was when Ghost Rider, the first one, came out. Not the old one, but like the new, when they did like a remake of it. Do you remember that?
Ghost Rider.
Yeah, Ghost Rider. You remember Ghost Rider?
That's from 2005. Yeah, or 6.
Not the one with Jack Nicholson. It was another guy, I think. Or Nicolas Cage. I don't know why I said Jack Nicholson. What the fuck? Nicolas Cage. Remember when your guy would dress... You can dress your guy up with a mask of Ghost Rider? You don't remember that?
No, that was a long, way before. It was like 2006.
That was way before? Boy, I swear I was dressed up like that. Like, when I was hanging out at theaters. Maybe we knew each other that long. You never know. Jeez, now you're making me think I met a different person. Even though I don't truly remember how we met.
So anyway, I was a
big, anyways, big troll. Skipping all that. You were a big troll at that time? Well, yeah, I was just me, the idiot that was kind of smart, but idiot.
Getting into fights with other players, that's how we met.
True.
I was fighting with someone about a random topic in the PlayStation Home Theater, and then you like said, "Oh, I'm on this guy, the blue guy's side."
Oh yeah. I didn't even know what you guys were talking about. I just chose a side. They're like, fuck it. Then we became friends after that. And even though I knew him for a very long time, I don't think we really played with each other after that. Like, after PSN. After PlayStation Home, I think
yeah,
I've only...
Time.
The only thing we played was GTA 5, and that was like two games, and that was it. Till now.
No, GTA 4, like in that time.
GTA 4, I don't remember playing GTA 4 with you.
Yeah, I think so.
I remember GTA 5, like, I had my friend from school playing with us, and you kept killing him, and I would jump in your helicopter.
Yeah.
That was, I think, the last time I played with you till now.
Anyway, We did a lot of fun stuff on PS Home.
Yeah, watch that movie. What did you do? I don't know what you did last summer. Something like that. Two, it was like number
I'll
two.
I always know what you did last summer.
Yeah.
The third one.
Hung out at your yacht or whatever it was. That small boat.
Yeah.
Me, I was a little poor boy. Couldn't afford all that fancy shit. So I just had the basic house. Yeah, that's pretty much it. There's like really no interesting things with us, just funny memories like that.
We pranked. What's his name? Shep Talk.
Shep Talk was a weird person.
Yep.
He was one of those people. Like if you play PlayStation Home, you already know that dressed up like a girl. Trying to get guys to give them free PSN cards. Our boy was like that. But we kept trying to expose his ass. It was funny.
Yeah.
And the funny thing was, I was the one that introduced him to PlayStation Home. So I created that cancer. I never talked to him ever since my account was hacked. And his was, he said that someone hacked him as well. Yeah, his account was hacked as well.
On my account. I still have him on my account, but he like hasn't been online since. And he's...
How many years?
I'm seeing right now. Shep Talk. He still has the image of the girl with the pointy ears.
Yeah.
One girl.
I know exactly who you're talking about.
Doesn't say how long it has been since he's...
It's been years, though.
Basically a deactivated account.
Yeah, they hacked him and then they deactivated it. Yeah, that's what they did to him. They hacked his account and deactivated his account and then gave it back to him. And since I didn't get to get a hold of him, exactly, the way I got a hold of him was through his brother. His brother deleted me, asshole.
Anyway, you created a girl account that literally just named girls and numbers.
Oh yeah, I remember I made an account like that to mess with him.
Yeah,
I was messing with someone with that. We both were on that account at times.
Yeah, and you had to like a girl who was interested in him, and then we were both at his digital house, and then somehow this person knew me and invited me there.
Oh, I remember
that.
How
do you explain that?
Do you remember that one dude I hung out with on PlayStation Home? The one with the account that I shared with him? That, Darkness dude? I forgot his name. Fuck. So, me and this dude. So, he was all about, helping, pretty much anyone that had, suicide thoughts. That were gay and were treated bad. Like, I was part of that group, sort of, with him. So we made this account where we'd help people. Like, we would get everybody to join our group. Because, you know, on PlayStation Home, you can create groups and all that. Like, that clubhouse or whatever. So we would do that.
Yeah, that was cool.
Yeah, we shared that account, but then when I got hacked, I pretty much have never talked to him ever since. Because I don't remember his ID name. PlayStation ID name, and I forgot the one.
Oh my god! I still have the girl 56789 thing.
I think I logged on there. I think I logged on to the account once.
A month ago.
Because I was trying to see if I couldn't get my account back, the one that was hacked. Seeing because I
that long ago.
Yeah, because
you're still using it.
No, I haven't used it. I just accidentally logged onto there because I was trying to get... Because when I was an idiot faggot back then, I created tons of accounts. I do mean tons. And for some reason, I sort of remember the names. And I usually put for my old accounts, I used to put three similar passwords. Now I use a different one because, you know, I don't want to get hacked. And I'm smarter now.
You should log into that again and do and let you should do, like do
troll
another
someone.
Prank.
Just troll people. We could do that. We could do a video. It'd be like trolling with Brandon.
Yeah, but what we do it on? Like on Nebula Realms when that
yeah,
comes out.
Yeah, when that it technically already came out.
I've not heard of it. I think, but also never heard of.
I can do?
Yet.
I think if I go log into it and I do sort of a share play with you, you might be able to download it. Cause it's in my library, so I could just download it. I could delete it and download it anytime.
So, are there a lot of people on there?
Not really, cause the thing lags and kicks people out. And since it's no longer in the store, you had to download it pretty much right away. I think it was only up for 2 weeks or something like that, Nebula Realms, before they took it out of the PlayStation Store. Because it had so many bugs. It still has a lot of bugs. That's why you never catch me on it. And since they haven't added a lot of stuff yet, it's pretty much hanging out in this bar-like place. I still like to troll people in there. So what I would do is I would go in there, since I'm pretty much, I don't talk to any of those people, because I found out anybody that plays it anymore is 23 or whatever. So I would log on there. Hey, you bastard, get off your TV and listen to my story.
Yeah, I'm listening.
So I would go on there and I would just go to the bar. So you know how there's seats on the outside and then you walk into the bar you're the bartender. So I would sit down in the seat, and I would, order something. Then I would run to the other side, and I would, act like I'm the bartender. So I would do both of these things at once, role-playing with myself. And it would just mess with people. I got so bad with it that people would, there would be, 10 people in there. They would stop their conversation and just watch me role-play with myself. And they'll be, they'll lose, they'll be, oh, I'm losing touch.